So this is
Emperor just shows for it. Yep.
the EV Extreme Tournament
Last card was just
2021,
Genius.
brought to you by Future Pastimes and the Museum of Science Fiction's Escape Velocity Extra.
Oh,
What
sweet.
EVX stands for.
Sure, go for it.
You can still sign up for this
When you get a half spice?
until the end of May.
I mean a half spice now.
If you're
Can I
watching
get
this
the
video or
duplicate of this
stream
one? I do
yeah,
need
you
cards.
can. And it's still May, you can still play games and sign up for the tournament. And the six finalists will win
I think we should let them
one
win.
of the following items. They can choose one of the following items each. There's a custom Dune game mat.
Information for that guild, if you
There's
want.
the normal
Oh,
Dune board game.
I'll tell you how I
Yeah.
got.
There's the Ixion Entelai Luxu expansion.
There you go.
The second expansion, which is Chome and Richie's, but that's not out yet, so you will get that when it releases.
Wait, what was
And
your Elixir
then
Tower again? The X thing? When you buy
there's
this,
also Dune
you
Movie
get the museum.
Edition, which is planned for a late 2021 release, so you
It
will
is
also
planned
get
for
that
that.
when it's released. Those are
So
the
that should be
items you
good.
can win in this tournament. Alright, so let's have a look at the game. Second.
Card totals. Go to revival phase.
For some reason, I think Tabletop Simulator is messing up my
I don't have to
every
worry
time I
about that.
start Tabletop
Tabletop
Simulator.
Simulators. I will.
My mouse doesn't work.
I'll take my one sideboard.
Well, we'll deal with it.
Can you flip it?
Okay, now let's actually take a look at the game. So it's already turn two, and I'm a bit late on this, but to commentate over the game. If I'm too loud or too quiet or they are too loud, just tell me in the chat. Okay, so Ian is our game master. He's in the black spot.
Sharp message to you, Harkonnen.
Over the Mole is playing as the Emperor over here. He's already allied with the Harkonnen. The Harkonnen played by
Makes sense.
I don't know where the mind games is. Hold on, let's try to figure it out by a process of elimination.
Dude, ship 7 and then split 8 and 8.
It's not Shroom, it's not Evil
I don't like
Clown,
my two
it's
strongholds under attack. I don't like that.
either Yeet Xing Ping or
I can ship.
Leona
It depends how much spice you have. Like the problem is Virginia is
or
worth some money. And that's the
the
problem.
handgun,
I don't
I
think so.
guess. But I have no idea. Hold on, I can check.
They will just ship four cyborgs.
One sec.
But it doesn't have spice though. How much spice did he spend? Six? Seven? He's very poor right now.
Let's just
Very poor.
ask him.
No, never mind.
Okay, so we have Handgun as playing as the Harkonnen. Maybe I can.
Four two seconds.
I'm doing it live. I'm doing it live. I'm doing everything live. But maybe I can do a
Harkonnen
little
said that he
overlay
wants.
over the
Here's my time. Two
names
more minutes, right? Two more.
so we
Just flip
keep
the coin.
track of who is.
Oh, I
Oh
was
no.
connected.
Same.
Got disconnected, but it gives us some time to get our
Yeah,
overlays right.
sure. He's probably still on his work call. Rip. Forget, is it
Make
only autoplay for the host?
will only autosave for the host. Leona, if you want to remake the game, make sure you're sitting in blue and then load the game.
What?
Here, I'm gonna message him.
Somebody knocked me down. Is this the first tournament game?
It is, yeah.
At the rehouse.
I'm talking to him
game.
In DMs right now.
Okay. Let me out. I'm in the wrong game. Hate.
Wait, where'd everyone go? The game's just gone.
Yeah, we all just disconnected.
Yeah, y'all just disconnected to get the rehost.
Oh shit. How do I save this so that when I rehost it's the same?
It will autosave. It already has
so if I just go to main menu and then rehost, I'll be able to pull up the same thing.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Make sure
you're sitting in blue before you load the autosave though.
Okay.
Atreides BG.
Just going to quit Tabletop Simulator for a moment because for some reason Tabletop Simulator makes my mouse.
Post these. My internet's not that bad.
Yeah.
Hey,
Leona,
could you change a card in my hand to one that's in the Emperor's hand? You know, the one that I told him.
Okay, autosave 3.
Yeah, your mic is crackling again.
Okay, yep. Okay, well, you need to just bear with me for a second.
Sure.
I'm trying to restart the game. Okay, so I rehosted it. My correct seat.
It is in. It's up.
I see a huge
yeah,
I'm
going back on
mute
because I'm still on this work thing, so.
Sure.
Alright. Here we go.
The scripts are kind of broken. Seems like, but...
Yeah, some stuff is broken.
I love
no,
it.
Rip.
We can deal with it, so it's okay. We can do it all by ourselves.
You can try reloading it again, maybe?
Nah, I think we're good.
No, yeah, it's okay, it's okay. Small things.
We'll blow it up anyways.
Yeah, we can ignore. So.
Alright, Leona, when you had the chance, make Pinecone black.
Yep, Hark, you can keep doing your turn.
I am typing.
Well, his name is very long, yeah? Okay, so...
Whoa, what's going on with the...
It was my turn, so...
No, there's a slip. There's a 6 here.
It's broken, yeah. Ignore that.
Just a glitch in the matrix. Don't worry about it, it's just tedious.
Okay, just don't hit the reshuffle button by the BG secret area. I don't want to know what it does.
Okay, I will ship 4 forces. Emperor. I think that will be enough.
Oh yeah, sure. Do you want me to pay for it?
Yeah. One, two, three. You wanna flip?
Ah, lol.
Could you increase the...
Okay, I have 1 more minute. I think I can use my 1 minute to think about your move.
Hey, Hark, do you want to know some card information?
Yeah.
Maybe you bought them, maybe you did not. I don't know about that. But I can
Hello?
Use that.
Could you increase the player count to 10? So I can join.
For a minute, it's very inadvisable. advisable for you to do that, because they might have cards in there that they might have had the better half of the pile.
They might have. I don't know that. I only know that you are the ones who seem to go for the win, but we'll see after the Emperor goes.
We bought one card between, or we bought two cards between that line. They bought all the cards.
Yeah. Well, we will see what the Emperor does anyway.
I think it's BG prediction, Matthew.
Well, I'm sure it's B. I'm pretty sure BG predicted this turn. I don't know if they predicted Harker X this turn, but well, either way, I'm here for it. If we lose to BG prediction the first game of the tournament, that would just about sum up my my doom career here. So.
Wow! All right.
That's a mistake. You're giving too much spice to the guild. Way too much spice to the guild.
We'd have had the spice anyway.
No. I mean, okay, well, it's your choice, but
yeah.
Hey, guild, do you want some information about the possible hand?
I'm allied to the X. I know what cards we have. I know what cards they have.
I know, man. Yeah.
The Emperor now guild can just doom stack you there or me if he wants to.
Fremen did buy one card last round, I think.
Yes, I did.
Jesus Christ, okay. For some reason, my mouse is completely fucked up. It's so frustrating. I don't know what to say.
Shit, alright. Okay, I understand what you mean by that.
I don't know how big, but it certainly is not lessened by me.
Alright, well, Fremen, what are you doing?
I'm not going near the Emperor. I mean, like...
The Emperor didn't buy any cards last round. It's all Hark.
It's all Hark?
If you do want to try for it.
Just see what this card says.
I can't reach him. I can only spawn there, and I think that would be... few...
I mean, if you don't attack me.
I mean, you can send these seven troops here and then deploy here if you want the spice.
I think BG can definitely beat up the X. That's not an issue. But why would the wrong lines? Okay.
Well, that was predicted. That's the problem.
They wrong lines. No.
If they predicted X can win, it's a problem. They're contesting three strongholds actually right now. I mean, it's not sure. They can ship. Yeah, X can ship auto forces there to win this fight because Emperor gave so much money, and Guild can just doomstack anywhere he wants to get that stronghold for himself. It's very scary right now.
But we also need to stop the Emperor, so.
Yeah, we need to stop Emperor Hark, win.
Okay. Yeah, but it's a probably.
They got the right pile, dude. They got the right half.
Emperor spent.
I have a very good deal for you, Emperor. Look. I move into Habania, you throw to me, that ensures that you don't win, and they will not win against you in this siege. So nobody wins. I don't know, man. I don't know what I can do in this situation, honestly. Like,
it could be BG prediction. That's very risky right now. I mean, this
Well, actually, I'm planning on commentating over the game at Aikmar, so you don't actually have to hear them. Problem is, I'm just dealing with technical issues right now.
Sorry, what?
Can you help me with the Emperor's hand, Ixion?
So give me a second.
Yes. I have a good idea of what's in his hand. I don't have perfect info.
But I can still probably turn him up a little bit.
Okay.
If they are really hard to hear.
So I will definitely help you.
You will need to... Yeah, like, look, man, I could go to Funeral Plane and just collect 12.
I mean, you can do both, move the 7 here and all.
Fine.
7 is not beating.
It might. I will say, yeah, that might. It's 7 versus 6.
Could someone in the game leave? I'm trying to rejoin as the GM. It's a maximum of 8 players. I believe Jane is streaming if you want to spectate. Though.
Zach, yeah, could you leave?
You could also just turn up the player count to 10.
Oh, Fremen, time.
Oh yeah, Fremen, use up a time counter.
I do use up a
time counter. Okay.
Alright, flip it over then.
Phew!
Now, finally, I return up a little bit. Yeah, I think I will still be able to be heard. Thanks for the help, Aikma, and welcome to the chat. Okay.
I'll give you as much information as I can.
We are in round two. We have Other the Mo playing as the Emperor, allied with Harkonnen. Harkonnen is played by Handgun. We have the Spacing Guild.
Sweet.
Played by...
Alright, BG, you doing anything?
Clown.
Oh, you...
And the Spacing Guild is allied already with the X. The X is played by Shrimp. Okay, we also have the Bene Gesserit and Fremen who are not allied. Bene Gesserit is played by Leona and Fremen is played by Cornell.
This is a tiebreaker point for Emperor and...
So, what has already happened here?
And then if
there's some spies, obviously there's been a worm or else there wouldn't be any alliances. Yes, exactly. This is quite a... We're being quite strict in this tournament,
I think we do.
Just to keep the time down so people don't have to commit to 12-hour games, so we are using these time chips here. That's what these poker chips are. So basically if you you have some 2 minutes or something for each action, and if you want to go above that you have to spend time chips. And in every round you have a steady income of time chips as well. Okay.
Remember half price.
Oh yeah, half price. So here, one, two.
I wanted to do something. What did I want to do?
You have some really good cards, BG.
Unfortunately.
Oh yes, I wanted to put the.
And then I will move.
Alliances on. So. Easier to see.
Actually, I'm gonna ship one more. I'm gonna ship two more guys. So here's another.
This is very difficult. Just my mouse. I'm not sure actually. I don't think you can create time chips.
So
but if you're in an alliance, you can probably just use your time chip for someone else. I'm not sure.
Okay.
That's how it works.
And then Guild Doomstack. Doomstack.
Alright, Emperor, allied with the Harkonnen.
Alright, how many do I need to beat him here? He has 9.
He has
so
nine.
Xian.
Allied with.
Yeah, so his maximum is 15, so I need to be able to put up 15.
BG alone.
Dial, so I need to have 15 there. I have, so I can ship.
And we have.
Do you need money?
Oh no.
The.
Okay.
Fremen.
Do you need money to dial?
6 spice. Ship 12.
That's
here.
Yeah. If he plays Fae, that will he'll still need more. Oh yeah.
I'm gonna Hajar.
I don't think you can do that. Can you do that? I don't think you can do that.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, because I'm in Karthag now.
Yeah, he's in Karthag.
3 movement though. Oh yeah,
yeah.
2 movements.
He has 2
okay.
movements, yeah.
That's good. Okay, nice.
Alright, you sure you don't need money? You got 15 spice?
Yeah.
Perfect, alright.
And I shipped into Karthag if you want an advisor.
Yes, exactly, so... in this turn it looks like the Emperor and Harkonnen are already going for the win. In the last turns, not super many fights have broken out, but apparently there was a fight. The Harkonnen were in a fight and the Ixians were in a fight. And then Ida died and the fighter died and some forces. So this looks like probably Harkonnen fought Ix and won. I wasn't here for the start of the game, to be honest. Oh, interesting. So in this round, it's round 2, we are in combat. So there's only one faction that can win right now, which is the Emperor and Harkonnen Alliance. They are in 3 normal strongholds, and they are also in the hidden stronghold. But I mean, okay, the Hidden Stronghold is 4 against 5 X in Subboards and 5 X in Cyborgs. Yeah, the 5 on the 6 on the shield wall is to move the storm marker. I'm not sure where that's there, but apparently that's what it means. Some weird version of the mod, I think. Okay, so got now the battle between Guild and Harkness happening over here. I can't actually take the tab to notify you, I think. I increase the size of my cursor. Mouse work.
I don't know why Guild Rep didn't come out.
It's interesting that my mouse is registering the clicks because you can see the apply button highlight, but it's just not working.
Guild Rep has won the battle.
Finally.
If you get tradered, I'm going to be really sad.
Maybe it's not a problem with the mouse, but with the processor. Okay, so the guild won, so there's no risk anymore, nobody can win anymore in this round. The guild only has 2 strongholds.
If we win, I get one. So either way, I get one. Okay, cool.
The Harkonnen just lost a lot of forces, so might be out for a while. But so did the guild, so okay. Harkonnen and guild not looking good. But, you know, I mean, the guild is sort of... The guild can always win at the end, so it's not so bad for the guild. And also they have a lot of money always, so
they
revive a lot over time.
If I mess up, it's not my fault.
You have a goal to get back to this person.
I know, right? I wish I had it.
Okay.
Alright, let's go.
Okay, you can see here in the chat over here, if you see my gray mouse cursor, not perfect for streaming, this gray mouse cursor, but can't do anything else. Okay, we're using tiebreaker points for the tournament. So normally if you win more than your opponent, then you are higher in the tournament rankings. But if you have the same number of wins, then the tiebreaker points count.
What was the question?
So you earn tiebreaker points in the shipment and movement phase.
Right.
At the end of the shipment and movement phase, if you have enough strongholds to win at that point, you just get one tiebreaker point immediately.
Trader?
Yeah.
God. Fuck. Fuck. And the Harkonnen earns a win for stopping.
And. Okay, so the Ixians were fighting the Harkonnen in their mobile stronghold, and a traitor was drawn by the Harkonnen, so the Harkonnen won. Ixians lost a lot of forces. I don't know why they're over here, they should be in the tanks, but okay. They lost 10 forces, 12 in total. They have also lost 2 leaders, so the Ixians are also not looking very good. Now also one of the leaders of the Ixians was captured by the Harkonnen. We don't know which leader, but
I doubt it. Okay.
Definitely the Ixians only have 2 leaders right now, so they're in trouble.
Okay, next is...
We also don't have Atreides in this game, and we don't have we don't have a Tleilaxo in this game, so you know, no easy reviving of leaders. That's definitely trouble. Okay, the next fight is Emperor versus the Fremen.
Or are you willing to just...
No, but I'd accept your
what?
Throw in exchange for not killing your leader.
Yeah.
Nah, I'm good, thank you.
So while this fight is happening, we can just recap a bit the game state. We've got... the alliances shown on the left here. And we have the Bene Gesserit has the Axolotl tank stack token. The Harkonnen has the Highliner stack token. Bremen has the Spice Production tech token, so the tech tokens are spread out. Nobody is getting a stronghold from that anytime soon. And not a lot of spice either. Spice on the board, that's just the 12 spice here. Bremen and Bene Gesserit are fighting over it in the next battle. Okay, so now this battle, Emperor. Where is the an X wheel? Am I blind? Why would the Ixians and Emperor be fighting? Okay, let's just look at this battle. Whatever is happening. They're going to be real or no? They're still thinking about
Oh, I forgot to start the timer.
Bremen win in
2 minutes to finish your battle plans.
Maybe that was just still there, okay. I think this is the Fremen Emperor battle. Okay, yeah. Here we go. So it's the Fremen Emperor battle right here in Hibania Siege. And it looks like the Emperor has won by using a Undersieger, and he even has Silga as a traitor, so he doesn't even lose any forces. Okay. So it's a good day for the Emperor. Won all his fights. Was able to use his traitor, didn't lose anything. So I suspect the Emperor will try to get rid of his Harkonnen ally soon. Because the Harkonnen are certainly not pulling their weight here. Especially since they have already revealed one of their traitors, so no, not many traitors left for the Harkonnen. I mean, they're not terrible, but you know, many forces in the tanks. And the Harkonnen can certainly do better. The Harkonnen could ally with Bene Gesserit, for example, would be the obvious choice. Okay, speaking of Bene Gesserit, the Bene Gesserit are now fighting Bremen. He has these little timers here, by the way.
No.
So the players have 2 minutes to think up their battle plans. And if the 2 minutes are up, they have to use their time tokens to extend their duration. Okay, while they are still thinking, we can look a bit further. We've got a Truth Trance has been used at some point. We've got nine cards in the discard pile. Okay, the cards in the player's hands, we will see that in the next bidding phase. In terms of the board, we have some pretty typical stuff, I would say. Obviously no Atreides, so at the start I bet the Ixians ran into Erekin. That's probably where they also fought the Harkonnen. Okay, we've got the battle. Another traitor, oh my god. So three traitors in one ground. This was the Bene Gesserit fighting with Fremen, and the Bene Gesserit had a Fremen traitor, so they win automatically. It was 5 against 6. So pretty close number of troops, but the Bene Gesserit definitely win. And they get to collect a lot of spice, because if 5 forces there, they of course didn't lose any forces, because they had the traitor. Okay, what traitors do we even have left? So the Harkonnen still have 3 traitors. The Spacing Guild still has a traitor.
No one's won. Oh, we got a storm. Everyone's gonna get a time token, and then Fremen, you can show the storm.
Storm will go 6, wiping off the BG from the board.
Anyone, any weather control?
We use the Silga traitor, or yes, the Emperor. The Emperor used the Silga traitor. Okay, so we still have some traitors left.
No, you
you can't move it. Hark has it.
Oh, Hark has it. You're right. I'm dumb.
Never okay, mind. So it's the end of the round.
I control it now.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. The storm got the Avengers at forces. They're in the tanks now, but who cares about the forces? It's just 5 forces. You can easily revive them in a few turns. And the Avengers isn't going to go for any kind of big shipment right now anyway, I suspect, so
sorry,
it doesn't really matter.
No spice and no troops.
Okay, so another worm. People are deciding who to ally with. The Ixians and Benny Jesuit are probably going to ally.
You got a lot of dead cyborgs there, I don't know.
I mean,
what's looking like?
Hey BG.
I still have a hand.
Hey BG. You have a lot of troops there. You want to move them around the planet?
Guild has no
problem. Do you want to be in the game?
No, Emperor, than the others? A real Chad to carry you to victory.
I'll
take X, actually. Fuck it.
Yeah, okay.
Just buy me
cards. Okay, so we've got our first alliance is Ixion and Bene Gesserit. Bit surprising to me, honestly, because the Ixians don't really look that good. A lot of forces in the tanks and a lot of leaders in the tanks are captured by the Harkonnen. But, you know, I guess it's the Bene Gesserit's turn. Maybe they just want some better cards. And it looks like the Fremen and Spacing Guild have allied, and the Emperor and Harkonnen are staying allied as well.
Let's go to Chome Charity.
Anyone else? Nope. Okay.
Going once on Ixkarama. Going twice on Ixkarama. Go ahead, Ix.
Okay, here we are.
Of course. You can look.
Yeah. I mean, that's really what it's all about for Bane Gesserit. Bane Gesserit need good cards to make their voice ability work. And the only people with any card knowledge are the Ixians. So I assume that's why they've chosen this alliance. Okay, so we're in bidding right now. Everybody has 2 cards right now, except for Guild only has 1, and Harkonnen and Emperor both have 3. Obviously, I mean, Harkonnen and Emperor, because they are allied, they will always have a lot of cards.
And that does not spell. That
nope.
Does not
nothing
spell
personal from it. I just I don't want this to happen.
Issue. We're good.
Yeah, we can ignore the. Yeah, we can ignore the. Well.
Yeah. That's my bad. I keep missing this.
Yeah. Ice appeared in Habania Urk.
Yeah, I don't disagree.
Well, it would have appeared in Havana Ridge Flat, but it was destroyed by the storm.
Okay, that works then. I'll allow you to do the thing.
This is the first card, I guess. Okay.
One,
so
right?
We're still setting up the cards.
Yeah, yeah.
Alright, we'll start bidding. We'll start with M.
I'm still surprised the Emperor didn't go for a better ally, but I guess he's going for loyalty right now. Like, Ixion is probably discussing with his ally. He's taking so long.
Yeah, you can go first. Remember, I got all the Stilgar spice.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And Jessel is really going for it. 7 spice for this card, so they must know something here.
Sure.
I mean, the Ixians don't know exactly what card it is, right? So
I would just let them have it, BG, right?
Okay, 8. Okay. 9 would definitely be too much for BG. I mean, none of these factions are very rich, so Harkonnen gets their card. 5 cards now.
plenty of cards to steal using this Emperor Alliance. Once again, bidding high. All the spice will come from the Emperor and go straight back to the Emperor anyway, so really bid very high.
You gonna show the spice?
I mean, I've shown 8 already.
You don't see anything.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll use that Gola.
Do you ever... So now Harkner is using a Gola to just to free up his hand. So that later when he later when he gets more cards, he can go full up to 8 cards and doesn't have to throw away a card. And of course, Gola is still useful. Okay, I guess maybe that was why Emperor stayed with Harkonnen, because he had a Gola, so really the lost forces are not a big deal. He just came right back, at least 5 of them. Harkonnen is continuing to build, and of course also Harkonnen does have a stronghold. Right now they just need to defend these strongholds, 3 strongholds right here, and get another one to win the game. Now it all makes sense for a strategy. And you know, the Emperor might know other things that we don't know. They certainly knew about that Gola card. I bet they also know a little bit about the traitors, maybe. Convince them to stay in that alliance. Maybe Harkonnen still has some juicy traitors left. Okay, next card is bought by the Emperor. Now both the Emperor and Harkonnen are full, so the rest of the players can now bid pretty cheaply and get some cheaper cards. Looks like bidding is still going pretty high. Got a 5. So that to me indicates that the Ixians have spotted a pretty good card in the deck. And they're trying to see if maybe the Bene Gesserit or maybe the Bene Gesserit can get it. Okay, 5 once again. No card going for less than 5. Like, I think that's pretty standard actually. In the games I've played where there has been no card knowledge, so no Ixians, no Atreides, mostly cards go for something like 5 spice. That's sort of the average price of a card. My mind, and obviously sometimes you can go higher if you are Emperor or someone has a lot of cash.
May I use my 3/3 revivals?
4 cards, 2 cards.
Revival, pretty simple. Should I use it? Emperor. Nothing spectacular happening here.
Your call.
Is your Emperor going to give Harkonnen spice to revive? I doubt it. I mean, they still need spice to ship in forces and also to fight, so I don't think it makes sense to 5 extra here for Harkonnen.
Okay.
Then, now it's...
Everyone don't get the perfect hand.
It's going to go into shipment and movement phase. Yes, Ekman is completely correct. There's going to be a lot of blocking. The guild definitely want to block, obviously. I mean, they always want to block. The guild and Fremen alliance is obviously the big Stalwart alliance. The guild can safely go for the end condition, knowing that the Fremen are not going to try to go for it, or at least they're not going to prevent them from it.
The revivals that they want. I think the BG token is triggered.
They're just trying to prevent any wins, the game plan of the guild and Fremen alliance, obviously.
Yeah, of course. Yep.
With the guild having 12 forces in the tanks, they definitely need some help. The Emperor starts, so he can go somewhere, but he's already in two strongholds, so I don't think he will go for a third.
You could suicide into the storm.
Any
If he doesn't go for a third, certainly the other players could just block it up with thrown fights. So maybe Bene Gesserit or Ixians could throw a fight or have a fight be thrown against them in Karthik or Siege Table, and then something in Arakeen as well. Then it would be all blocked up. Or maybe the players are looking for the tiebreaker points. That might also be interesting. I mean, this round, I'm pretty certain. I mean, unless everything is blocked up, okay. The guild is just moving out immediately, so the guild will not block anything up. The guild are going for the deferred responsibility approach. Mr. Interject and Pass is sort of the meme we have on the server. Interjecting at the start and just passing or moving out forces just to say, you know, I'm not dealing with this, you all have to deal with this win attempt. It's a good strategy usually. I mean, in this case, I feel like it might be too risky. I mean, the Emperor and Arcanine are certainly looking strong. They look like they have a game plan. They've been in an alliance for some turns. I think this is a little bit too risky maybe, but see if it pays off for them. Bremen at least going into 2x siege, so...
If you want, you can walk into...
By the way, the guild moved forces from Karthik and then shipped from 2x siege using the cross-plan shipment to free up the space for... Bremen.
You are, yes. Yeah. But they will not have Ornithopters.
But no thrown fights happening. So that's quite surprising to me. Yeah, I was definitely expecting some thrown fights, but nothing of the sort. Fremen are just trying to hope they are enough here. I mean, I guess from the guild and Fremen perspective, okay. Bene Gesserit and Ixians, of course, they can win with fewer forces. They have the voice, they have card knowledge, and so on.
No.
Okay, so it looks like they are spreading their forces over two strongholds to stop the win.
No, but I mean, he can't move advisors into a space with fighters in it.
I think
no, they flip the fighters when he moves to Imperial.
Well, I mean, my understanding is advisors in a territory with no others.
I don't think it's broken up like that.
Okay, so we have some rules questions here.
In between inhabitation.
Let's check the new FAQ. I'm pretty sure it's legal, but let's double check it. Sure.
So this is our first tournament game, so actually our first very competitive game. So we've had some small competitive games in the past, but it wasn't anything as serious as this. You know, there are a lot of prizes to win here. And also the honor, obviously, of beating people in a serious competition like this. I'm not sure how many participants there are, but it's something around 25 or 30. So if you can say, you know, I was a finalist of 30 people, or I won the tournament with 30 people in it, then that's obviously... a lot more, holds a lot more weight than all our competitive events in the past. So people are, seem to take this pretty seriously so far. Having to look at the rules now. And so it's about this move here from Arakeen to Karthik, the Bene Gesserit advisors, can they move from Arakeen to Karthik because they are advisors, and in Karthik the forces are not advisors. In my recollection, they can simply move there and then flip. They have to flip to normal forces, and okay, that it looks like that's what they've done. Okay, my instinct was correct, and it moves on to the next players. Okay, the Ixians just did nothing here.
Maybe the Ixnas don't have a lot of spies.
Yeah, I know, I'm just leader. I'm just tight on leaders. That's literally it. That sucks.
And he doesn't have leaders, of course, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, the Ix did move into. Sorry, I missed that. The Ixians did move into. Ship, sorry, into the Ixian stronghold.
Yep.
Challenge the Harkonnen there. So it's 1 against 4 here. And now the Harkonnen are moving into in full force. Okay, this makes a lot of sense. Very strategical play here. Building forces between Ixians and Bene Gesserit. I'm pretty sure the Harkonnen still have some traitors for us. Bene Gesserit or Ixian traitors are very likely here, in my opinion. Splitting the forces here just to have some more chances of winning. The Harkonnen will first fight any battles against the Ixians, so. Okay, so yeah. The Bene Gesserit have 6 forces here, the Ixians have 2 Saboids and 2 Cyborgs here, so Saboids sort of count as half and Cyborgs count as double, so it's basically like it's 6 and 5, so it makes sense to split them up like this because one group of forces is not really that much better than the other group of forces.
Actually, there's 5 strongholds. It doesn't matter if I move one of them, right?
Nope, because we're not fighting on tech tokens.
Is this guy here?
Yeah, that guy's in the hidden mobile.
Okay.
You know what the best part of this win attempt is? Even if it doesn't work, I'm not the part of the alliance that gets...
Tech tokens are not going to matter here because the Emperor and Harkonnen have split them between each other, so they can't... form a complete set of tech tokens to make a stronghold. Okay, the Harkonnen is still thinking over his movement here.
Okay.
I mean,
that is all. Okay.
You say it's GG unless X has a hack traitor, but I mean,
people might get more type
he still has, he still has
okay.
Yeah. One. Okay, he has. Okay, I see what you're saying. Okay, I forgot that. At the start, X also lost against Harkonnen, of course. Yeah, that's what I missed at the start in the first round. So obviously, Harkonnen actually got two of captured two of X's leaders. So Ixians only have a single leader left. Two are in the tanks, and two are owned by the Harkonnen. So one leader against. In 2 battles, you can't split the leader, so in one of these battles, you cannot use any cards in the battle unless you have a cheap hero.
Well, no, chemistry doesn't count as a snooper, because nowhere on the card does it say snooper. It would count as a poison defense, but that's a different text.
Yeah, different. So, yeah, can you use the Karama now?
Yeah, well, sure. Karama that voice.
No voice.
Okay, so Kurama card was used, one of only 2 in the deck. Kurama was used to stop the voice in this battle against between Harkonnen and Bene Gesserit. Makes sense, you know. The Ixian fights are going to be easier because of that leader problem the Ixians have. The Bene Gesserit don't have a leader problem at all, so the voice is definitely more important here. So it's 8 Harkonnen forces against 6 Bene Gesserit forces. And let's see if... the Harkonnen and Emperor Alliance can win here.
You can get my battle plan, Emperor.
Well, I can't. Oh, Jesus.
Harkonnen has used the shield snooper and fade rofer. Okay, so this was supposed to stay secret, but I don't think it's going to matter personally. I think they've got this in the bag. I think they can win here in Karthik, and I mean they can definitely win against against these decimated Ixians with too few leaders. Okay, just not even a contest. Okay, they do have artillery strike, but it doesn't matter. Both leaders die, but...
So if my leader died because of artillery strike, even if he would have killed it, he still doesn't get the money, right?
He doesn't get the spice, no.
So actually, Pyta does survive because he is using Shield Snooper. So nothing for Vayne Gesserit. Harkonnen do lose a lot of forces, but it doesn't matter now. Yes, they're just going to win this now. I mean, probably they're going to even win both of these fights. That's my opinion. We're going to have a pretty quick game one here, tournament game one.
So who was it that said Hark turn 3 was a peanut brain?
Maybe they will go for a second game here. That might be interesting.
I shot myself in the foot by suggesting that prediction.
It's over so quickly already. And we had, so many people worrying about 7-hour games and guild stall-out victories. I mean, this is what happens in competitive play now.
I believe in you, but no.
Turn 3 and already a victory. I mean, it's not over yet, but...
no projectile defense.
Yeah, full expansion definitely helps. I mean, the Ixians are always the faction that, as long as the Ixians are included, play is going to be very, very, very quick, just because of their stronghold, their extra stronghold, and also they're pretty strong faction at the start, so they can often have the opportunity to win turn 1 or 2 or something like that. And even if they don't win turn 1 or 2, then other people are going to have to stop them from winning, and stopping them from winning is going to end up with some factions with a lot of forces in the tanks. You can see it here. Already so many forces in the tanks, and that is going to just give the other factions a lot more freedom to attack and go for the win. So that's why we're at this situation now. We're pretty okay, and another Kurama, so Emperor and Harkonnen drawing so many cards using the Emperor ability to basically get free cards, and using the Harkonnen ability to draw extra cards. They've drawn so many cards, and they've been pretty lucky to also get both Kuramas. So they've used another Kurama here to... Oh my god, I thought for a second, wait, is that a third Kurama? No, that doesn't make sense. Just drawn it off the discard pile. Okay.
Second battle instead of the first.
I just want to take some time to think about it. That's my reasoning for that. I'll probably do the same, but I'm just...
Whatever.
Didn't you use it on the first battle? Like, the voice was blocked.
Some shenanigans happening here. I think Harkonnen was Harkonnen trying to take back the Kurama and use it elsewhere, I think. I think they've just kept it as it is.
And are you?
Kurama or cyborgs? They can't have one now.
Are you Kuraming the dialing on the cyborgs?
Yeah.
They count as one force.
They count as one now. Okay, so the voice is still that?
Yeah, same.
Okay.
Okay, so Kurama was not used to prevent the voice, but it was used to prevent cyborgs from counting double, which makes sense, I think. I mean, the voice is not really going to cause too much trouble here, really. I mean, the Harkonnen have so many cards, I don't think the voice really matters at all here. So just preventing them from dialing very high is sense to me. Okay, Harkonnen's still mulling it over. They have a minute and 30 seconds. Ixians have taken the battlefield back as well. Oh, now it's come back again. So some indecision here. Harkonnen finally have revealed it, and I think it looks like we're going to see the first win here. Okay, Poison Blade, Poison 2-0, and another traitor. Wow. So Harkonnen just had a lot of Ixian traitors, got lucky with getting the great traitors. I mean, if the Harkonnen had gotten this traitor when they captured a traitor, then might have ended differently, but okay, in this battle they were certainly winning, no matter what. They didn't really even need the traitor. Okay, and the game is over. And let's see if Bandy Rusted
Can you just have predicted an Emperor turn 3 victory or an Harkonnen turn 3 victory? But first, just to be correct, yeah, during this last battle, so Ixians did have Beast Reborn, sorry, as a traitor, so they got a little bit unlucky. The Harkonnen used the right traitors in all the battles, so no Harkonnen traitor was ever called, and the Harkonnen win the last battle also, as I predicted. So now let's see if Benny Jesuit got lucky with their prediction. I doubt it. Oh yeah, Ixion turn 5. This is a pretty classic prediction, I would say. Ixion's turn 5. Usually you don't really see predictions as early as turn 3. Yeah, Ix had no leaders in that last battle, so they couldn't even play any cards. So they were doomed to lose immediately after losing the fight in Arakeen. And I mean, we didn't know if they had a cheap hero or not, but obviously they didn't.
Yeah, there's three traitor calls here.
Yeah, crazy first game, over in 3 turns, lots of traitor calls. What was it, 4 or 5 traitor calls? We had these 3 traitors by the Harkonnen. We had Harkonnen, the Emperor's traitor called, which was... what was the Emperor traitor? Oh no, that was Stilgar, sorry. Yeah. So Stilgar was the Emperor's traitor. These 2 Ixion traitors were Harkonnens. We also had the Bene Gesserit call a traitor on the Fremen.
And then the 2 cards that got from the auction were Lasgun and Karama.
And that's how the first game ends.
All the other cards in that auction were garbage too.
Like, I can't believe you dialed 7 here. Like, with voice shut down and shield snooper, I thought you would be a little less conservative with your dialing. That was very...
I think it's because they easily saw that Ix can do nothing to win those battles unless they trade or called.
If I had one more, then he would be lost, yeah.
Like, I'd given Hark Fade in the food, so... I was hoping the other 5 was the traitor, and that was the one that you picked up, but no. Because I figured he had 2 of those traitors.
Brutal, it's brutal. You said it was Bashar who was safe, not Bursic.
That's it, Bashar. Okay, sorry. I meant to lie there.
It's fine. It wasn't binding. We were allied.
Yeah. I mean, I thought it was Bashar. Like, it wasn't intentional.
Oh, well. I still doubt I'm going to do very well in this tournament, but at least I was part of the first win.
Yeah. As a note, in the future, games are going to be allowed taking notes.
Oh, I would have won if I'd just taken notes.
Oh, I wouldn't. I didn't want to change anything on my side, but that would be.
Would have predicted Hark turn 3 if note taking were allowed.
Yeah. So note taking is going to be allowed just because it's impossible to. It's impossible to keep people from taking notes, so you might as well allow it.
I said it does make it.
Yeah. Again, congratulations to Handgun and Over Tomorrow for winning the first game of the Dune tournament. Earning quite a lot of tiebreaker points too, probably, just for holding so many strongholds for such a while.
Like, I mean, technically, you helped me a lot, but...
Here, I'll post the results in game 1.
I'm one tiebreaker point short, but I got the victory point, so...
Yeah, that matters a lot more.
Yeah.
It's giving money to the Emperor, guild, like... 40 spice was way too much. Like, I knew they were going to go for the win.
I was basically just gambling on your traitors because I knew you had 2 X's, X traitors.
Cry.
They were a good one.
Yeah, I was like, it's Hark, and I'm like, I have no agency in this. This feels bad.
Like
I can now dial you. I just don't know.
You can sort of metagame Hark in a weird way.
I can, because he was going aggressively after
me. Let me put it this way. The Hark don't get to choose their traitors, which means people are
they get to choose their
more
target.
likely more likely to play high traitors against high leaders against them. So Hark will take fights where they have people's high leaders more slightly more often.
Yeah.
We can meta that all we want, but at the end of the day, like then you have to think, well, then people would catch on and play their low leaders, and it's a cycle, and you at the end you just gotta pick one.
There's not much you can do when they pick such good cards. Two Corals.
Yeah. Like, we're really lucky. Like, yep. We played well, but we were also really lucky. Like, the last one.
Going to Alliance as well, it's like, what are you gonna do?
Good traitors. Shields number with pet save.
Yeah, no, I got Poison Blade, which I'm thankful for, honestly, during that one.
Man, you did pick that. That
was the same pile of Shield Snooper, by the way, Poison Blade. Yeah, and it was all the weapons. Yeah. It was like the best pile I've ever seen in this game.
Yeah.
It was like three weapons,
Poison Blade.
You have a pile, and you know that this game is going to end in two turns.
I was hoping to be the one that was ending it, but...
Did you put the Shield Snooper on top?
No. I left it in there because I wanted to purchase it.
Oh, okay.
Because I was greedy.
So in the last bidding phase, you know, Ixion saw the card, and that's why Bene Gesserit bid so high, they were left with Ixions. So they were trying to go for the Shield Snooper, but, you know, unluckily, the Harkonnen and Emperor got it. I mean, that's what the Harkonnen and Emperor Alliance is all about, you know, getting lots of cards, filling up the Harkonnen's 8-card hand, filling up the Emperor's hand, and it's all basically for free. So, that's how you get lots of Kurama cards and Shield Snooper and so on.
That was we almost win. That wasn't we almost win. Because we almost not lose. Moment. Like,
all right, well, I'm heading out.
Maybe
some of you tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm
maybe
leaving.
Not.
So, lobby's about to come crashing down.
Fine, I got all the information that I need from it.
Guys, thank you for the game. See you.
Thank you all.
Yeah, and that's it. Thanks for watching. I'm going to try to stream and record some other tournament games as well. People who might be interested in the tournament to stay up to date on all the games, how people are playing. You know, maybe some tournament participants will even watch this just to see. I mean, if you really want to be competitive, you could even watch other people to see how they play and so on.
Yeah, well, yeah, because I'm just going to run them.
Thanks for watching.
Whatever.
Yeah.
I guess it doesn't really matter as long as it's consistent for the game.
I'm adding Harkmal to the rules document. It's like the only homebrew rule we're using.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was a pretty brutal game for that. What other traits did they have? They're two Ixions.
Yeah, I wasn't even looking. I think they had two Ixions. They had like Safe Piter and then like one other traitor that I think they called. They had like a Fremen traitor. They had like
absolutely
Stogar or something.
Destroyed the Ix there. Destroyed. It was brutal. God, blimey. All right, nice one.
Yeah.
Yeah. GG guys. Thanks for GMing.
No problem.
Oh, I see. Yeah, so do the results like that.
And thank you for watching. And I'm going to enter. Okay. Bye.